This video is about how to use Salesforce Lightning Object Creator to create a custom object from a CSV spreadsheet. The spreadsheet we're using for this video is for outcome harvesting. Special thanks to the outcome harvesting community, and especially Michelle Jared from Ripple Peace Research and Carmen Wilson Grau from the outcome harvesting community. The first step was to gather a representative sample of data fields to be used. And you can see I've got some sections here, description of change, significance, contribution summary. And you can see there's a whole kind of other information here that we're tracking on as well, plus some help fields, substantiation, levels, and significance, lots of stuff. But the whole point is, if you're gonna build this custom object from scratch, that's a lot of work. So the whole idea of this is that any organization that wants to give this a try can use this process to actually create this object and test it out. For testing, I ended up losing the help screens and also the sections. And you'll see I've bolded some of the interesting fields just that we want to see, especially you'll see, because what I had to do was to transpose this in order to make it work. So taking a look then at the transposed version, what you're seeing is we have, again, this is the types of change, and if we flip back, we can see here types of change, you know, was a whole series of fields here. Again, this is just awkward to have to look at it this way, but this is a multi-select pick list. Because the type of change has seven different selections in the multi-select pick list, what that meant was is that all of the other fields needed to be padded out to that same level. So even though this is a checkbox, and we could just use true to make it identified, we actually had to build it out so that it would actually do the import. Looking across this, again, what we've got is checkbox fields. We have pick lists, and here's a pick list with low, medium, high. Then we had to pad it out, three additional is the way it's viewed, to be able to make the matrix full. Evidence type, same way, we had to pad it out. Contribution, we ended up padding that out as well, and replicating across these other ones. Percent also needed to go out, so I just took that down. And lastly, just a placeholder for category with four records, but we needed to go on ahead and build that out as well. So what you'll see is, because there are four unique values, that's what the pick list will do in terms of creation. You'll also notice there are no relationship fields. This is truly a flat file. We export this, and I tried a bunch of different ways. This was the simplest. So if you do a download and you do it as comma separated values, looking at Salesforce, I'm in the Outcome Harvest sandbox. And what I'm going to do is to go to Setup, and then go to the Object Manager. And then when I look at the Object Manager, what I'm able to do is to create a custom object from a spreadsheet. It says log in with a sandbox. Log in the sandbox. You then have to allow it to do these things. So I'm going to allow. Then I'm going to upload a spreadsheet. I could have done it with these others, but I found was the simplest. So I'm going to do an upload of the CSV, which is this last one, and I'm going to open it. And you're presented with this custom objects screen. We can leave the encoding the same. It is a CSV file. We're going to let the field labels, these labels, be detected from the rows. And remember, this was what our source sheet looked like. So if we go back, this was the row that they're talking about. And so we start out looking at that row. There, the field label row is the first row, and they're finding seven rows of data in addition to this field label, which makes sense. So we're going to import that. I'm going to let it create a default record. This is something you could talk to your Salesforce administrator about, or there's different ways of looking at creating record names. But I want to just show you how this is going to work. What I have to do now is, these are all text fields. This is a date field. That's a text field. That's a checkbox. So it's actually pulling it the way I need it to. What you'll see is this one is the multi-select pick list. So that's the first one I'm going to change. And then I'm going to also see that I have some out here. Anyone that starts with none, I'm also changing to pick list. And it's just clicking on it and selecting it. All right, so I've made those changes and just scrolling through it. Again, what I'm looking for is just to make sure that I've validated that I've got all these. Anything that's not a text one is a pick list. It's better to do it now than to have to fix it later. Great, so we're all set. Say next. We're going to change the name of the object. You can change these settings based on your internal policies. I'm going to click Finish, create the object. You can see it's doing things here. So then we get this success record, a kind of relative. It says we couldn't import all of your row data. So there's something that was missing, but for now we're okay with that. They detected 41 fields, they created 41. They detected 7 rows, they imported 7 rows. So we're happy with that. So what I can do then is to go back to the object manager. And at this point I can do a refresh just because it needs to see the current version. I'm going to do a quick find on outcome. Look at outcome harvesting, and it says we have these records. Now you'll see they're now in alphabetic order, but if we look for a pick list, you can see behavior change description, and we scroll down, what we're seeing is that we have information in those pick lists. The next step is to go to tab, take a look at your tabs. Looking at your tabs, actually you're really way up high because you could have to scroll down, but you don't have to here because we see outcome harvesting and it's there. And you can see these other ones have kind of managed information. So this tells us that this one is a custom. So we have a tab. It's currently a box. Then what we need to do is to manage the app. So I'm going to go to the app manager. And then you have to decide what application you want to add this to. So for me, I'm just going to add it to the Nonprofit Success Pack because that's the standard app that I use. So the available tabs, these are selected tabs that are available. I want to look at the available tabs. We know we just added this one. This, for some reason, isn't in an alpha order, but we do get it at the very bottom, so it's okay. So I'm going to go to Outcome Harvesting. I'm going to add it. And then we don't use leads, so you know, actually I'm going to take that one off. And I can, there's lots, get starting settings, other things I can do. So I'm going to take this, and let's just move it up because this is really important to us. So I'm going to put it up here so that I actually see it. And then I'm going to save. That allows me to then return back to my home page. I'm going to, at this point, go in and I'm going to take a look at the Nonprofit Success Pack. Looking at it, what you see is we have a tab called Outcome Harvesting. So I click on it. Comes up with Recently Viewed. Nothing's been viewed. So we want to see all the records. And it shows us there are 7 records. So this is just a list view. If you go in here, you can actually select the fields to display and other things you want to, but we're not going to worry about that for now. What I just want to do is to show you now that I can do a new record, and this is matching the order that I, from the spreadsheet. So I'm able to do the type of change, I'm able to do significance, I'm able to look at here about contribution, evidence type, and then to get down to substantiation. So you can see that it actually created it. So for now, I'm just going to cancel it because I can't, but that actually would allow me to create a new record. What I do need to do though, is I do need to go out now and delete all of these because these are just kind of the empty records that I pulled in. And the good news is that the object manager has all the fields that I need. So that's a first step. Just want to make sure you know this works. And now we can go into a next phase of cleaning it up. But thanks for watching, and I hope you give outcomes harvesting a try.